Now,
Just we have discussed about the particular impact of GST on manufacturing sector, COVID impact, and real estate business. And now just service sector also we have discussed in previous session. Now we will discuss in second session impact of GST on agriculture. Now we know well agriculture is very very important, and you know very well means 75% population of the country are purely depends on agriculture, and agriculture is very very important role while playing very significant role in GDP, and the newly implemented indirect tax regime is influencing the agriculture industry and farmer. And due to 5% GST rate on agriculture product, means now in agriculture product have only a 5% GST rate. So this is the things. The rate on fruit and vegetable juice, jam, sauces, purees, mix, concentrated and house processed foods have been set to 12 to 18%. This is the rate. And taking into the consideration food consumed by the poor, food grain and milk have exempted from tax. And after GST, your poultry farming, dairy farming, stock breeding, these all keep out from the definition of agriculture. Earlier before GST, it was agriculture. Now, first questions before us, that what will the impact of GST on agriculture? So this is the particular things. The main impact of GST in agriculture would bring in the inflation, with the currently 4% VAT being increased up to 8% on many food items including cereals, grain, as an exemption under the VAT is limited to the unprocessed food. Means there is no GST on unprocessed food, only processed foods have to pay the particular GST. New tax rate on pump set has been reduced to 18% from 28%. Before GST, the rate of the pump set under 28% GST rate, 28% tax rate, but after GST, it is only 18%. So price of this pump set will be get reduced. If 5 get reduced, ultimately demand will be there. And pump set play very significant role in cultivations, and it is heavily used in many states of the country, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Maharashtra, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, and many more. So in decreasing of pump set, there is no significant impact, only price will be cheaper. The GST Council has announced 12% tax rate on agriculture product, and later it has been reduced to 5%, I mean 12% to 5% tax rate has been reduced on all agriculture products. And now 5% GST rate will be applicable in all kinds of agriculture, allied products and agriculture products. So this is the particular aspects. And this is very helpful for the particular, you know, farmers. And this will means helpful to the farmer, and productivity of agriculture may increase. Now dairy farming, poultry farming and straw breeding, as already been said, this is exempted from the definition of GST, and another GST rate will be implicable. First question is, there is there any chance to impact of COVID on GST particular agriculture? Of course some impact would be there, but before saying that, I am coming to the point, fertilizer also play very significant role in the cultivation, and fertilizers an important element of agriculture was previously taxed at 6%, 1% excise plus 5% VAT. In the tax regime, tax on fertilizer has been increased to 12%. Now here, tax was 6% on fertilizers, now it is 12%. So gap of 6% will ultimately boost the farmer to use the manuals. Manuals means traditional manuals. This will be highly, means we are talking about the green products, we are talking about the very hygienic products, and farmer will just get, you know, promoted, get motivated with their manual, you know, all things in the particular agriculture land. This will be helpful. The same impact on tractors, tractors rate on the manufacture of tractor is removed and GST 12% has been imposed. This is beneficial as now the manufacturer will be able to claim input tax credit. Mean GST tax rate is 60% tractor. Tractor also play very role in agriculture. If this rate is there and manufacturer will get promoted to produce this particular tractor, the tractor's rate, there is no significant impact on the rate of the tractors. Currently, only 2% VAT is charged on milk and certain milk products, but under GST, the rate of fresh milk is nil, and skim milk is kept under 5% bracket, and condensed milk going to be taxed at the rate of 8%. Condensed milk, processed milk, and fresh milk. Fresh milk, no GST. Concerned milk, pay for 18%. So I mean, milk allied product, up to you if you want to get the fresh milk for the particular milkman. So this will promote to the milkman. The price of tea might also increase due to the tax rate of 5% under the GST rate from the current average rate is 4.5%. Means current rate was 4.5, only 0.5% rate has been increased tea. So ultimately, when you are talking about this particular rate of the GST on agriculture, there is no significance of the particular rate. Matter is that COVID-19. After COVID-19, what do you feel? The cultivation or productivity will increase or decrease or sustain, or there is an impact on the particular cultivation price. But as for my money, so many migrated people has came in rural area. They will be motivated go for the cultivation, their parental cultivation. So ultimately, productivity will increase. When productivity is increased and production increases in the country, ultimately, there is no problem of food items. Modi government also announced till December or November, sorry, till November, there is a free distribution of rice, wheats, and grams in the village area, urban area, as well as rural area. And from the supply from the agriculture, it is continue. So there is no particular impact on the particular agriculture area. Agriculture will be protected. There is no significant impact of COVID on agriculture. Only the impact would be on manufacturing sector. If agriculture goes to the further processed in the particular meal, this will be the problematic, then agriculture spread product will be increasing. So as for COVID impact is concerned, this will not give the impact on the particular agriculture. Now, impact of GST on Indian economy. It is very, very important because Indian economy nowadays, you know, third largest economy, very big economy is there. And we are approaching here and there. We want to boost up our economy, our GDP. So impact of GST on Indian economy and impact of during this COVID era, what are the impact? First, I would like to discuss a reduce tax burden. Means reduce tax burden. Tax burden has been reduced of the particular taxpayer. Everyone know 5%, 8%, 16% and 80% tax slab is there. So everyone know well the tax burden has been reduced and different tax barriers have also been reduced. Like, do you remember, an unpreserved item has to move from Kolkata to Delhi, Maharashtra to Delhi, and some or Delhi to any other place. I mean, from agriculture farm to urban area. And in the way, there is provision of toll plaza, which leads to the wastage of so many wastage of unpreserved item. But after one tax, one country, one tax regime, this barrier has been stopped. So trucks and this vehicles will move this with this product ultimately direct to the destination. So it will miss penalty was goes to the particular higher, you know, warehouse